day and welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about the first law of thermodynamics. We learned a few terms and formula which link to the first law of thermodynamics. This include the heat energy, internal energy, and also the work done by gas during expansion or compression. The first law of thermodynamics tells us that the heat energy supplied to a gas will be converted to the work done by the gas to expand and the increase in internal energy. The equation is given as delta Q equal to delta U plus W. Q is representing the heat energy supplied to the gas. The first two formulas for Q have been already introduced in Form 4 physics, which is about the heat capacity and specific heat capacity. The third one is something new in Form 6 syllabus, which is molar heat capacity. The definition for these terms are listed here. For molar heat capacity, we have two types. One is the condition of constant volume, another is constant pressure. We could see the specific heat capacity is linked with the mass of object, while molar heat capacity is linked with the number of mole. From this equation, we can find out both these two terms can be related with the molar mass, that molar heat capacity equal to molar mass multiplied the specific heat capacity. Come back to our topic. The next thing is about the work done by the gas, which is about the volume expansion. The gas could do some work to increase the volume of container. When the gas applies force on the piston and push out a distance of X, we can get the work done by the product of force with the distance. Here, we can substitute the force as the product of pressure and area based on the formula P is equal to F over A, and then we can obtain another formula for the work done is PdV. From this formula, there are two cases could be discussed. First one is when the volume of gas is constant. Since there is no change in volume, there is no work done by the gas. Second case is when the pressure of gas is constant. When the gas undergoes expansion, there is positive work done by the gas. Here we could apply the formula PV equal to nRT to replace the pressure in the equation, and then we can get another formula for work done, which is nRT ln V2 over V1, where V2 is the final volume and V1 is the initial volume gas. Now we're going to link the first law of thermodynamics to the molar heat capacity. The first case to be considered is when the volume of gas is constant. As I mentioned that there's no work done by the gas, so when there's heat energy supplied to the gas, it will be converted into the internal energy of the gas. Here, the heat energy will be equal to nCVm multiplied change in temperature of gas. Next case is when the pressure is constant. Now, there is work done by the gas. Here, the work done is expressed as PdV, or we can have another formula as well. From PV equal to nRT, we can get the work done also by nRdT. So what happened here is that the heat energy supply will be used to increase the internal energy of gas and also to increase the volume of gas. From the equation of first law of thermodynamics, the heat energy now is nCPM multiplied change in temperature. And then we can also express other variables in terms of change in temperature and number of molecules as what we have did just now. From here, we can simplify the equation and obtain CPM equal to CVM plus R. So this is how we could relate the first law equation with the molar heat capacity. The next thing to be discussed is about the degree of freedom. We're going to consider one molecule in this case. As what we have learned in chapter 9, the internal energy of gas can be expressed as F over 2RT. We are going to review back again the condition when the volume is constant. By the way, you now should be able to see a pattern. The work done is zero when the volume is constant, and this is why we always start with this to do a lot of derivation in this chapter, that we can reduce the first law equation into delta Q equal to delta U. Here, we are going to substitute the heat energy as CdVm dT equal to dU. The CvM is equal to dU dT. We can put in the equation of U, and we can get the CvM is equal to F over 2R. The next step is to use back the equation we just derived, CpM equal to CvM plus R. From here, CvM is equal to F plus 2 over 2 times R. In this topic, we also introduced with the term ratio of principal molar heat capacity, gamma, which is the ratio of CpM to CvM. Substitute the previous two equations of CPM and CVM, we can obtain the ratio is also equal to F plus 2 over F. Overall, we can identify the types of molecule based on this equation in this slide. With the defined heat energy supply and the temperature change, we can obtain a molar heat capacity which could be linked to the degree of freedom that is unique for monoatomic, diatomic, and polyatomic molecule. Let's try the question from past year in 2020. An ideal gas is heated at constant pressure. If the increase in the volume of gas is 400 cm cubed and the increase in internal energy is 100 joule, what is the heat absorbed by the gas? Here the condition is constant pressure. We are given that internal energy is increased, du is equal to positive 100 joule. And as for work done, we can apply the formula PdV to obtain positive 40 joule since the volume is increased. Hence, the total energy supplied to the gas or the heat absorbed by the gas is 140 joule. Next is question 17. An ideal gas is cooled from 50 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius at constant pressure. The total heat liberated by the gas is 2.5 times 10 to the power of 4 joule. The molar heat capacity of the gas at constant volume and constant pressure are given. First question, determine the change in internal energy of the gas. We are given with the molar heat capacity, but without the number of mole. We have the equation of delta U is equal to NCBM delta T, and also delta Q is equal to NCBM delta T. So what we can do is to perform the simultaneous, divide the first equation by the second equation, and can eliminate the unknown, which is the number of molecule. We will have U over Q is equal to CBM divided by CPM. Put in the values, we can obtain the change in internal energy is negative 1.79 times 10 to the power of 4 joule. You can see that heat energy is negative. It is released by the gas. So the internal energy of the gas in this case is reduced, and the volume of the gas should be also reduced. Next is to determine the work done. To supply the first law equation, we can get work done is about negative 7,100 joule. And you can see that it has negative value. The work is done on the gas. For question C, what happens when the volume is constant? First point is always about the zero work done, that W is equal to 0 joule, and we have delta Q is equal to delta U. During the cooling process, the heat energy released to the surrounding is supplied by the internal energy of gas. Here we can calculate the internal energy by NCBM dT. Since those three terms are constant in this case, delta U is still negative 1.79 times 10 to the power of 4 joule. And then the heat energy liberated has also the same value as delta U. From here, we can conclude the heat energy liberated is lesser since there is no work done to compress the gas. We shall look another one from past year in 2019. Here the question is quite normal, except it mentioned about monoatomic. Well, you should already know that the degree of freedom is equal to 3 for monoatomic. With this, we can obtain the molar capacity on our own that CPM is 20.775 joule per mole per Kelvin. To calculate the heat absorbed at constant pressure, just apply the formula NCPM dT. You can obtain the heat absorbed is 24.16 joule. Let's see one last case from SMJK Chunghua Confucian. We are given with the data of internal energy at different temperature. We have the equation of delta U is NCBM delta T. We can calculate CBM by 1 over N multiply the change in internal energy divided by the change in temperature. We can take the first set and the last set of data, which is 0 and 50 degrees Celsius, to obtain the average value of CBM. In the end, CBM is 21 joule per mole per Kelvin, while CPM is 29.31 joule per mole per Kelvin. The next question is to determine the type of molecule. Here we have both molar heat capacity. You can apply any of this formula, including also the ratio of principal molar heat capacity. We get the degree of freedom is 5, which is diatomic molecule. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you still have any question, leave it in the comment section below. And I will see you in my next video. Thank you.